place.
Now, you're inside the compressor. It pushes the refrigerant through the tubes in a big loop.
Oh, hey! It looks like there's a soda bottle jamming things up.
A soda bottle? Oh, for crying out loud!
What? I thought it was a garbage chute. It's not my fault the door isn't labeled.
Ah, okay, Bing. We need to remove that soda bottle. But be careful and make sure when you do
it, Zay. Soda bottle removed.
Bing, you gotta get out of here. Fast! Bing, can you hear me? Bing!
Hey, StoryBots. Why do moths always go to light?
Space bots in outer space!
Captain's log. We are on a routine mission to scan the mysterious region of space known as the Cocoon Belt.
Huh? Ensign Hub! Ensign Bob! How many times do I have to ask you to stop playing with those legs?
A ship! A ship!
Red alert! Stations, everyone! Checkmark! Report!
Something very large is slamming into the ship, Captain!
Sensor readings. Sensor readings indicate that the threat is a giant moth.
Checkmark, take evasive action!
It is still following us, Captain!
Captain! There's a hole breach on deck 88!
Captain! The fusion reactor is close to a meltdown!
Captain! I've fallen and I can't get up!
Hottie! Engineering report!
Captain, I'm doing the best I can, but the ship can't take much more of this!
More moths approaching! 30 seconds to impact!
Ensign's Hub and Bub! Scan the...
Lights.
I told you to... Wait a minute. Spork!
Yes, Captain.
Aren't moths attracted to light?
Yes, Captain. According to records, many insects, including moths, use a light source to help them fly in a straight line. One common theory says that before humans or StoryBots, the only consistent light sources on Earth were the sun and the moon. By keeping them at a constant angle when they were flying, moths and other insects could be sure they were moving in a straight line. When other lights are introduced, moths become confused and are attracted to those lights.
Spork, that's it! Prepare a glow rocket set to full brightness.